Ja. Hello, everybody, and thank you for joining us here on a Saturday evening at 3 p.m. Let's see. I see there's a couple of you is already there. Francesco, Dajan, Götz is there, Naidu, hello, and a few other people are joining. Talia will also join us in a moment. She's still trying to connect with the call. If you want to comment during the course of this call, there is a chat function. If you look on the right side of the window of the video, there's a chat function where you can send messages and where you will be able to communicate with us today. And what do we have planned? I hope to keep this call halfway short. I hope for maximum 1 hour. And we want to discuss with you or to share with you from the steering committee the first steps that we did in the strategy process. As you know, we are trying to define together a purpose and a strategy for the ALDE Party individual members. And this is a process that has been going on for several months already. And at our last meeting in Brussels, we came up with both a vision for these ALDE Party individual members and a mission for the ALDE Party individual members. And we want to share these first steps with you so that you can then take it into the individual members in your countries, to the individual members in your regions. And we hope that you will start a broad discussion with events in many, many cities to discuss this strategy proposal that we put forward to you. And we hope that in the time from now, basically till August, you will have a lot of discussion with the individual members about the vision and the mission that we put forward to you. We hope that you will offer amendments to our proposed text so that we can, in the end, create a refined document that we will share at the annual meeting at the next Congress, and which will then be voted on by the individual members. And from there on, we will take it further to put the strategy then also into concrete actions, while at the same time always including all the members as much as possible. Yeah, let me get started. I hope for a moment that Talia would join every second now. I'm sure she will be with us any moment. But let's get started, and let me share with you what we have done so far. My proposal is there will be three areas that I will talk about. First, how did we start this process? What was our basic motivation? Second, the vision statement, which I will explain in a moment, and the mission statement. And after each topic, we will have time to have a discussion with you, so you will be able to let me know your thoughts on the points during the chat that we have here on the website. Let me share the screen with you. One sec. Let's see. So hopefully you should be able to see. Oh wait, I need to do one more thing. So now you should be able to see. Yes, that's good. Yeah, the strategy process for all the individual members has started already about a year ago, and we have been working on this as the steering committee regularly on some time. You'll remember that we started with a survey among the individual members where we asked for your vision for Europe and for ALDE Party about, I think it's over a year ago already, and we refined it. And at our last meeting in Brussels, the steering committee came together to, let me see how I edit this. Oh, no. Came together And we try to define what are the most important things that we care about, what are the most important things that we think the individual members should be focusing on. And I invite you to play along, so to say, because the first question that we asked ourselves is, what do we actually value in Europa, in Europe? What is it why we are engaged in politics? Why do we actually care? And what is our motivation to come up? And this was a very useful process. And when you put this this proposal in your national and regional communities of all the individual members, my advice is, or my suggestion is, that you also start with this, that you start a discussion with this question: what do you actually value in Europe? Why are you engaged in a liberal party? Why do you want to do politics on a European level? Because it helps you very much to clarify what your motivation is, what your purpose is of what you are doing. Because for me, for example, I'm not in politics to change the tax law by 0.5% or so. I'm in politics because I care about certain values and I want to create a Europe that will fit to the values that I share. So here's a few of the things we wrote down in this brainstorming without any specific order, just as they came into our mind. You know, and feel free to see how they fit to your belief system and which points you might have added yourself. An open society is something that we as the steering committee value very much. Fairness, progress. We want to see that citizens in Europe develop themselves, that they can build a better life for themselves. A point, not surprisingly, that came up was the value of science and the value of facts, which are constantly under threat now all over the world. Human rights, the political and civil rights of the individual. What I in Germany would call this individualism, but I know understand that in English language countries, individualism might have a little bit different connotation than what I think. So political and civil rights of the individual were a strong point. Rule of law, power is also responsibility. We need checks and balances, minority rights, and. And maybe you have points that common security, Rainer writes here. And many, many other things that can be said. And the next step that we did as a steering committee after we had this basic sets was basically to metaphorically put a gun to our head and make us shoes. Because there's always, excuse me, I needed to take a sip of water. There's always a lot of values that we care about, but what we really care about is easiest to define if we make you choose. So if you would have to choose one value, which one would it be out of this list, for example? Now, if I put a gun to your head and I say, you have to choose, which value would you choose? That's something that helps you really, really fast to find like the North Star of your belief system. And if you have this this North Star, then you have a compass that you can always follow in all decisions that you want to make, be it in politics, be it in other parts of your life. So let's take a moment here. I would like to ask you, and please write me in the live chat, if I would put a gun to your head, which I won't do, I'm not a violent person, but imagine for a second, I put a gun to your head and I make you choose one value that you really care about, that you care the most about. Which one would you choose? Sven writes, economical prosperity above all. Maybe we get two or three other feedbacks. What are the, as well, before we move on? If you have to put one value that you want, that you care about in Europe, what would it be? Please write them. Freedom, Diane writes. What else? Maybe we connect maybe two more, so So we have a little bit of picture and then we move on there. Federico, progress. Yeah. And maybe one final. And freedom again from DK Jackie. Yeah, this is very similar to our process, to what we found out when we discussed this. Reiner, peace is also very valuable. And this is the same what we had when we made this exercise in the steering committee. It helps you to put your priorities in order. And the three values that we came up with, and I hope we will discuss this all over all the party during the next 2-3 months till August, were these three values. First of all, the rule of law. We numbered them in priorities, first one, second one, and last one. And the first one was the rule of law. Because if you don't have the rule of law, then nothing else can work. You don't have individual freedom if you can't be sure that your rights are protected. You can't have minority rights if your rights and if the law is not upheld at all times. A good example for this is our friend Yuri, who you might have heard got arrested just a few days ago in Moscow together with four other LGBT activists for the terrible crime of wanting to start a conversation with the Russian government. Yuri was in Moscow in order to deliver 2 million signatures against the harassment of the LGBT community in Chechnya. And he and his colleagues got arrested while they were packing the signatures into boxes in order to deliver them to the general prosecutor. They were not protesting, they were not doing anything, they were just preparing these boxes to be delivered. And that already got them arrested, which is, by the way, unconstitutional, even by the Russian constitution, which shows that if you don't have rule of law in a country, then nothing else doesn't matter. You can't, you don't have minority rights in this case if there is no rule of law. And you need to rule of law in order to protect the political and the civil rights of the individual. That was something that came surprisingly fast, became clear in our conversation in the steering committee, that when you get the root of it, what makes us a difference from social democrats, from Christian conservative people, and from the Green Party, is that in the end, we care about the individual person and its prospect in life. So we want a society, we want a republic, not where the government is in charge, where the state is in charge, but that starts every discussion from the individual and his rights and his needs or hers. And if you have that, that leads automatically to an open society, meaning a society where everybody is valued, not despite the fact that she or he might be different than other people, but because she is an individual, because she is different from all other people. Yeah. So these were the values that drive us in the steering committee. And I'd like to take a moment to ask you, what do you think? I'm talking all day long German today, and in my mind I get mixed up with German and English. I'm very sorry. So I want to take a moment to hear your opinion about these three values and how you feel about them. Do you feel that they point into the right direction? Or would you say your personal order would have been different? Or which questions can I answer you about this part of the strategy process? All of this was, by the way, this was before we actually started to formulate a vision and a mission. This was just to get our North Star right. René, hi. Please share your thoughts with us, René. Götz writes that he agrees with the points, but he would put them in a different order. And I do ask, yeah, how can you drive a political system taking every individual in mind? Well, in my mind, this refers to what a society is based on. You know, Hobbes had this idea that the individual gives his personal rights up to the governments in order to get protection from the government. And in the moment when you give up your rights, they are gone. I think in our viewpoint, I think I speak for the others as well, we see government as a place where citizens come together and they share together their ideas how a country or a society should be run. They don't give up their rights, they just organize them together. So in the end, for us, it's, or for me it's at least, it's about the idea that in any case, the government, the economy, society, even ecology, no, the nature, in the end, it should serve the individual. And it should help you to live your life as you want and not as anyone else wants. Okay, Diane writes, Francesco agrees with the points. Diane writes, what I agree most about is when you said about individual viewpoint, too many collectivism and protectionism in today's world destroy creativity and freedom, thus destroying progress and development. Yeah, wonderfully put, Diane, I completely agree. René says, yeah, I do value diversity, but we still work well together. Yeah, and I think there is no contradiction. Sometimes they make diversity and cooperation, individualism and cooperation as antipodes, but they are not, you know. It's if you really value someone for his unique personality, then you want to help him to succeed, and you will find the people that will help you succeed. And you help each other to become the best version of yourself, to talk like a 80s motivation speaker for a second. Okay, there's more. Reimer says, yes, core liberal value, without rule of law, the rest doesn't work. René, also, plus it's also good that you feel in the EU, yeah. Federico says, only thing is that overemphasizing the rule of law begs the question of who makes the law. Static laws by a benevolent dictator are not conducive to human progress. Europe is leader in human progress. Federico, I feel you. I feel you, man. Oh God, this is terrible today. I totally agree with you. And we, you will see when we come to the vision statement and to the mission statement that we exactly take this point up, who's making the rules. Getz says, yeah, he agrees with Diane's argument that the core value for him is the open society. And yeah, that's something surprisingly that happens for us. And when you put this into your discussions with the national members, in the events that you will do with the national members, with the regional members, I would not be surprised if you make the same experience that we made in the steering committee. We started off with stuff like how to organize society, do we need a European Parliament, and so on and so on. And through the discussion, about the values, we very soon came to the point that we defined, hey, all of this is only valuable if in the end it allows you to live your life freely, if it allows you to have your rights, your dreams, always respected and valued. And that's what the open society is all about, you know? That you can be yourself and you can prosper being yourself, not to the idea that someone else has. Are there someone coming? Talia, is that you?
It's me, hello.
Hey, Talia.
wait, I'll turn on my camera as well.
Yeah, 1 second, I will stop the hub. Here you are.
Hi. I
can... Hello, Talia.
It's just us?
No, we are quite a big group and a growing group right now. Okay. I'm checking right now on the other monitor to see if Now they can see you. Now they can see you.
I can see me. I can see you guys. Hi.
Yeah, you can see us, and
I can see you at the moment, Chris.
Say what?
I can only see you at the moment.
Yeah, yeah. The others there in the chat, they can comment on the live chat. If you want, you can open on your mobile phone and you can see the live chat. Otherwise, I have a second computer here where I see what they write, and I will read out what they comment on what we say.
Great, great.
You know, so what I have done so far to put this all together, I made a good number of inappropriate jokes, and also I tortured them with my beautiful German accent, and then I explained the process, how we started to define the strategy by talking about values. And mm-hmm. we just come to the end of the point where we had the discussion about values that we from the steering committee feel the individual member should be about in the end, which is the rule of law, political and civil rights of the individual, and the open society.
Yep, true.
You know. And the question, what do we value in Europe, brings us to the next point, and this is, what do we actually want? What do we want for Europe in the first place? And what do we want because of Europe for the ALDE party individual members? And if it's okay with you, I for a second switch back to my presentation.
Go ahead, please.
Okay, let me see.
Okay.
Present to everyone. So now they should see the presentation again. And I need to go to it. You see, we are excellent prepared here.
Yes, Chris, you're awesome. You got this. You should do it alone next time. I'm kidding.
Well, you will take over in the second half, you know. So when we talk about the future, you are basically the future of this process, so there's the point.
Welcome to the future, guys. This is the future.
You know. So the second thing that we ask ourselves following this value discussion was, of course, yeah, what do we want for Europe? What do we want for the European Union? What do we want for Europe? What do we want for the ALDE party individual members? And we did the same process as with the values. We brainstormed a little bit. And here's a short list of the things that we found. First of all, we want to run and we want to win elections. Huh? Because you can have the nicest values in the world. If you don't have the power to implement your dreams, then the world will not change. Huh? Which is the second point. We want to implement our vision for a better Europe. And then again, we came very fast to the motivation why we do this in the first place. For example, one thing that became pretty clear was we want to choose the candidates that we put forward based on merit and help to get them elected. We don't want to choose them based on quotas or from which country they are or from power perspective alone, but on their personal merit. And then we want to work hard to get them elected. We feel when we see that how organizations like Pulse of Europe grow across Europe like a wildfire, how many new members the Lib Dems were able to gather in the UK after the Brexit decisions, after we saw the great victory of Emmanuel Macron and En Marche in France, we feel that actually we as a pan-European party, we cannot be satisfied with 3,000 or 4,000 members at the moment. Our ultimate goal must be to have like 1 million members across Europe. And this, the thought that came out of this was that, yes, we want 1 million members who work in Europe for a better future, but we want them to be active members. That much became immediately clear. We don't want to be a party where the top leadership makes a decision and everybody follows in line and does what they are told. That's not what individualism, that's not what liberalism is about. We liberals, by definition, are a pain in the ass. No, because each of us has their own hat and we all want to do stuff on our own. We all want to implement our own ideas. So we want members who are very active, who get an idea how to put things forward, how to put society forward, who start to promote this idea and to start to implement it without waiting for us to tell them what to do, but simply they go out and do it and then they push at us to do more. We also want to build a party that's based on respect, where we treat each other in a respectful way. We want a party that's modern and innovative, that really stands for progress, that doesn't defend the past, but that constantly tries to improve on the future. A member-driven party, that's basically in what we said above already. We want you to push the party forwards. And we want to have a diverse party. A party that represents all parts of our society, men and women, all kinds of sexual orientations, young and old, all kinds of heritages, all kinds of religions, all kinds of social status as well. And that means that if we want this party, we have to make a conscious decision to look out for people who are not like us, who believe in the same things that we believe in, who are liberals, but who are not like us. So personally, for me, personally, I make a pledge to myself that I will actively look to find more people who are in every way different from me. In other words, people who are women, who are young, who come from different backgrounds, who might come from paths of life that are very different from my own experience, and I want to find these people and I want to help them get along. A pledge that I personally make to all individual members. We want to empower individuals, so we want you to get a to get something out of Europe and of the party as well. We want you to be able to influence the decisions in Europe. And that means that we have to have control of the legislative initiative, which means, and that was the point that you also mentioned before, is we want the citizens to be in power. We don't want a federation of nation states. We are states among each other make decisions. We want a republic of citizens. We want the citizens to be at the core of a federal Europe, and the citizens we want to decide, which means we need to give power to the European Parliament. And the European Parliament must have every right of a normal parliament and elect a European government that's accountable to the parliament. And of course, this all goes down to the point of one man, one vote, and no taxation without representation. If we finance Europe, then we also want to have a say as citizens. So this was a lot of thoughts that came into this brainstorming session. And again, we had certain topics that we personally found the most relevant ones. And for us, we came up with this top three as what we want for Europe. And the number one point was, in the end, we want to empower individuals. We want to give every European citizen the chance to make the best of his life, no, not by becoming a welfare state who does everything for you, but to removing all the obstacles that keep you from being successful, and to give you support that you can fulfill your personal dream, not the American dream, not the European dream, but the dream of you, what you want to become. That means we need control of the legislative initiative. Means we need to have a majority in the European Parliament, or at least we need to be the strongest party in the European Parliament, and that's what we want to work for. And we need to have a party ourselves who is very diverse, who has people from all backgrounds coming into the party and making a career in the party. Yeah, this is what we as the steering committee came up with. What do you think? Let's open the discussion. I will read a few of the comments that are already here and give you some time to comment further on. Let me see.
Well, I can also read the comments here. And as far as I can see, almost all our members agree with what you said. So I think it's really very important to hear from them now. What are their comments, their views?
Yeah.
What do they suggest?
Yeah. Please write your comments on this point about what do we want for Europe in the live chat right now, and I will read them out. I will start a little bit above the line here. Ronald asks, could we add economic and social rights to the political ones? The right of property and decent income. From our thought process, we wanted to, we discussed this, of course, as well. From our thought process, these are included. When we talk about civil rights and political rights, then this economic and social rights, they are included in this. Because you cannot fully participate in a society if you don't know what you will eat tomorrow. No? So we sub-summarize them under this political and civil rights. Nido says he likes to work with active members. Yes, we do too. You know, personally, I hope for a party where you don't ask for permission, but you ask for forgiveness. No? Instead of asking if what we think about a certain idea, simply go out and do it. And if it turns out to be a bad idea, you can still apologize later on if anyone complains. But go out and do stuff, because that's how we drive the party forward. Okay, Sven writes, much more direct feedback in between the European Parliament members and their activities and the voters. Yes, I agree with this. I think the interest in the European Parliament will increase dramatically once there's actual power that they have. But now they don't have any power to decide anything. I will put you back on I will start a video again, Talia. Okay.
Yes, please.
Yeah, okay. Oops. So, okay. Let's see. René writes, yes, we can increase members, but we need more organization. As example, in the European movement, enroll via their mobile phone. We should have the same facilities. Yes, good point. No, if you want to grow, then we need a better organization. We felt that before we can ask members in big numbers to sign up, we first need to have a proposition what we actually want to achieve. And Talia will address this part about the future, how we go on from the strategy process and what this actually will lead to in the second half of our call today. There will come these practical questions like, yeah, how do we plan to develop concrete activities that will lead to more members, more power, more results? So.
Okay. Shall I start?
We need about 20 minutes or so, because we first have to discuss the vision statement and the mission statement. And then we come to the part, to the outlook, what we will do after this call, basically. Ron says, I disagree with the comment that social and economic rights are included in the civil rights. Our political force will certainly use that for unjustified attacks. Maybe for just for clarification, these values, they are not something that we explicitly communicate outside at this point. They are just for us internally, so that we among individual members can discuss what we care about. You will see in a moment we come to the vision statement that we formulated and to the mission statement. And there you will see how we try to put this into more concrete context. So, Götz writes, I'm 100% behind the idea that the representatives have to be diverse. The question is how. In my National Liberal Party, that's also my initial Liberal Party, there were several programs targeting women, and the results were actually worsening. Yeah. I know what you talk about, Götz, I think this will be a very interesting discussion that we will hopefully will have among members in the coming months. How do we actually achieve these goals? So, okay. If it's okay with you, then I come now to the vision statement and to the mission statement. Or is there anything else you want to add at this moment about the values? Outside, anything?
No, no, I'm covered. It's okay.
Okay, great. Then I move on to the vision statement. Oops, here we are again. So, present to everyone. And here I am. Yeah. Yeah, this brings us to the actual vision that we formulated. And the vision, you must imagine like this. If you think like 20 years into the future, 30 years into the future, and it's now, what is 13th of May, 2040, for example. And you look back at the path that we took. Huh? How does Europe look today in the year 2040, for example? What kind of Europe do we live in? What kind of life do we lead? How is our party? How do we work together in a party? And the vision for this Europe in 2030, 2040, or whenever, that we as the steering committee propose is this. And by the way, I will send you the text, all of you, I will send the text later per email. Is this our vision? The citizens of Europe live in an open society. Individuals are empowered and shape Europe's future. The citizens of the European Republic are sovereign. They exercise the legislative power through the European Parliament and through European citizens' initiatives. The rule of law guarantees their political and civil rights. Liberals from across Europe and all walks of life come together in a diverse party to build a continent where the only fields of battle will be markets opening up to trade and minds opening up to ideas. So that's our vision for the future of Europe and the future of our party. That's the party and the Europe we want to build. And I welcome your comments on that now, before we come to the mission statement. How do you feel about that? What's the first thought that crossed your mind? Talia?
I'm really sorry, I can hear you, but I can hear with beep, 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 beep. I can, the only thing I did, it's just, I read the vision.
Yeah.
And then yeah. I had something like beep, beep. I mean, I don't hear you well. I just hear a beep. So maybe, okay, wait, I will mute myself. And also, I'll be out from the camera, and I'll join you again, okay?
Okay, okay, good. Okay. See you in a moment. Yeah, Ronald writes, 1 second, let me make sure I don't miss any one of you. Ah, Rainer was the first. Rainer said, one member, one vote, sounds great. Ronald, in the vision, we miss governance structure, what government, what president, which federalism? For us, the main point that we propose is that legislative power must be with the European Parliament. No? So that, of course, we want we don't want to decide everything on European level, but we want to decide all the things that all Europeans, that affect all Europeans. Those things needs to be decided in the European Parliament. And the European Parliament should elect a European government. We haven't made it more detailed at this point, except the fact that we want subsidiarity. Means everything that can be decided on a local level, on a regional level, on a personal level should be decided there. And only the things that only all of Europeans can decide together, only those should be decided in a European level. Okay, René looks good. Federico, good stuff. We shouldn't argue about it. Perfection is the enemy of the good. We need to start with that very good starting point and get acting. Naidu also well formulated. Yeah, this is what we hope for you as the coordinators now. We hope that you will take the vision and the mission and take it into your local groups, your regional groups, and your national groups and discuss them there and get feedback from the members and get the members engaged and invite them to contribute to this vision, to offer amendments to it and changes to it. And Talia will explain in the second half of the call, she will explain the process, how we want to facilitate your feedback and to make sure that all of the party can really contribute to this. So this is not the final version. This is our first proposal. And the final version will hopefully be voted on at the Congress in Amsterdam. Okay. Then let's move on to the... Sven says a bit too long content, however, good. And let's move on to the mission. No? So if you think about the vision, that is the... This is Europe 2040. Then the mission is, if you turn around and look back at the way that took you to this destination, how did you get to the vision? And that's the mission statement. And the mission statement that we propose is this one. The individual members act as a voice for European liberals that are committed to building a fair and open society, that are committed to the rule of law and the separation of powers, and that are committed to find European solutions to European issues. The individual members enable a pan-European debate that empowers citizens to fight for an open society. We actively engage liberals in building a more diverse and member-driven European party. We, individual members, we make ALDE Party the driving force for the creation of the European Republic. We develop policy proposals in a deliberate way and build alliances with national parties to shape ALDE Party. So please fire away all your questions about the mission statement. What's the first question that you might have? While you write, I will take a sip of coffee.
Okay, and I have a question. Sven said a bit too long content, however good. That was about the other part, about the vision. Right? About right. The vision.
Exactly. That was about okay. The so, Ronald likes the mission statement. Thank you.
As far as I can see, they all agreed on that. Good.
Yeah. Awesome. Yeah. We are now with the mission statement. Which questions do you have? Do you feel that we crystal clear? Very good. Francesco agrees with the mission.
Okay, great.
Yeah. I want to stress one point that I find is relevant is we want the members of ALDE Party to be the driving force of ALDE Party. And that means that we, if we want to change things, we need majorities. And we can, at the moment, in the way ALDE Party structures, we need to work inside ALDE Party, but also inside the national parties in order to shape a pan-European party. And we encourage all members to be active in politics in the European level, but also in the national, regional, local level. René writes, not all ALDE national member parties are equal supportive to our federal structure. That is correct. That's why we need to build majorities. No? We will never convince all people, but we can work to build a majority, and we can slowly change the perception in the other national parties as well. Okay, Dajan. Personally, I do not like the term European Republic. I think we shouldn't go so far. Other than that, everything is formulated nicely and seems like an optimistic world we are building here. Yeah, that's something that we will discuss in the few months that are ahead of us. Should a European Republic be the goal, a federal republic of Europe? Should it be a a federation of nation states that work together. What kind of Europe do we want? No? That's something that we will discuss during this in the next few months till August in your local groups, in your national groups, in your regional groups. Dajan, also the head of Dajan, Federico. How will there be some minimum action plans suggested for national coordinators? Yes, there will. That's what we will discuss with Talia in the second half. Okay. Any last comments before we come to Talia's part and the road ahead from here? This is your last chance to discuss the mission.
Wagner, Reimer, he has a question. I'm missing the sentence in peace.
Can you repeat, please? I didn't hear you very well.
I'm missing the sentence in peace, says Reimer Wagner.
Yeah. Yeah, Reimer, feel free to add this as an amendment. We will come in the next steps. You will see how you can, you and all the individual members, we will be able to influence the final version of this text. This is, both of them, they are just drafts at the moment. This is our proposal. And of course, we will discuss them in all the party, and there will be suggestions from you how to change the text, how to make amendments. And then at the Congress in Amsterdam, we will vote on a final version of that. Ron says, yes, European Republic is the program of the Austrian member party. That's correct. It's also the program of the German party, even though we call it Federal Republic of Europe. But that's for many European liberals a final goal. And here we go. That's the ideas, both the text for the mission statement and the text to the vision statement I will later send to you. So you have something to start with. And now I will hand over to Talia, who will talk to you about the road ahead, how you should discuss this in the national, regional, local level. Here you go. The floor is yours, Talia.
Okay, can I see also the PowerPoint so I can have the bullets?
Yeah, but then you will not be
visible. Oh, no, it's okay, Chris, don't. It's okay, I have it here in front of me.
Very good, yeah.
Okay, so first of all, I would like to kindly ask all of you to join, and let me tell you exactly the name, Country Coordinators Channel on Slack. Since till now, we only have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 members there. 6 of you have already joined the channel on Slack. So please go ahead and join all the others, because this channel will be your home, your secret place, where we will all be there discussing all this Chris just presented to you. Okay, so about the next steps. Strategy discussion on national and regional level. The thing here is, and I'm going to be honest with you, and this is something we, all the members of the steering committee, we keep discussing it and keep saying we should do something, we should ask our coordinators to invite the members to be more active, etc., etc. So we need you to be present to all this process, meaning that you have to comment on this. We have to be sure that we are all agreed on this, or at least the majority. And then you all have to address all this vision, the mission, the strategy, everything to all of your members, and ask your members to join and help you. And because we have this channel on Slack, it would be very, very important that you also upload your ideas there. For example, I can see Renee on Slack at the moment. Renee has an idea about how we can deliver our mission. Go ahead, Renee, and upload it. Post anything you want, your idea. What do you want to do? How you want us to work on that idea? Then, for example, Raina will come and tell you, no, this is not good. We should follow this step. And through all this debate and all this process, we can have the best results. That's for sure. But we really need you all to be present there. And only then we can work together and bring the best results, okay? This is about how we will work. Then it's Slack, I already told you. Yes, and I already replied to a comment on our Facebook page. My friend Wolf, he told that he told me, he wrote to me that Slack is not working, but we do believe that we have to use all the tools provided to us. And since we don't work too much with Slack, we should do it now, because we also have members who are not, who didn't join us on Facebook, and they have so many debates on Slack. So we have to be also there present, not only on Facebook. Well, Facebook, it seems like we turned Facebook like our blog, when we only post things we like, we read, or just like that. So let's have Slack as the place where we can work together and propose things. It's also a secret channel, a secret place. No one else should know what we're doing, not what we're proposing. What else? After all this process, we will all come together. Of course, we will be there for you, all the members of the steering committee. You know that we are in charge of some countries. I have, for example, seven countries has Chris, also Julie, Fabio, and Yuri. So do not hesitate to drop us a line or send us an email, a message, anything you want, and ask us things. And maybe you want Germany and Greece work together with something, or Bosnia. Then we will discuss it with Chris, and we will have a bigger group. Anything you want, please ask us. We will definitely help you, and I hope that you know that till now. And when we finish all this process, then we will be ready to propose our amendments. But we do really have to follow the certain process. It's not that we support the individual freedom, but first of all, we have to work together on that. That's for sure. So please, all together, join us and let's do it. Then after all that, we will have the General Assembly, and it will be in December, I guess. Yes, in December in Amsterdam, when we hope that we have a large amount of a big number of our members. So we will have final drafts there, we will have our amendments there, and hopefully we will also have more delegates. We had 3 this year, maybe, and I think we can achieve a bigger number. We will propose and we will present all the mission, the vision, all the final decisions we had. And we will, I don't know, Chris, we will also vote for them. Chris? Okay, I will ask him again later. And I also, we will organize, we think to organize, and we are very close to reach it, because we have to.
Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yeah, now. We will also.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
You? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Talia?
Yeah.
Hi, Talia.
Hey, I can hear you. You?
Hello.
Hi, Chris. Shall I continue, I guess?
Ah, finally.
It was your fault.
Yeah, I'm very sorry. Suddenly I lost sound.
It's okay.
But now it seems
the only thing I asked to you is that when we are in Amsterdam,
because I missed part of what you said.
I said that when we're in Amsterdam, in our
I missed part of what you said.
Which
did
one?
You discuss already that they should have events with the individual members in their city,
yes,
in their region?
And the whole process that they should propose their members to join and work with them and ask for ideas and anything. They should also join Slack. And
One second.
Now? I can't hear you now. I lost you.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Apologies. You know, I lost your sound first. Then I switched to my second computer, but there's a 30 seconds delay. So I always hear the answer to the last question. So just to get me up to speed again very quickly, did you discuss with the coordinators already that they should have local events, regional events with their individual members to discuss this?
Yes, but to be honest, what I think they should do firstly is that to work together, all together, our coordinators on our channel on Slack. So there they will propose all the ideas they want for the vision, the mission and anything, and comment and also upload anything they want so that can we all discuss it together. And also, even if they think that Germany and Greece, for example, should work together on something, they should also be encouraged to contact us.
Yeah.
So that we help them, because they have to know that we are there to help them, to support them, to anything. But the only thing they have to do is just drop us a line.
Yeah, exactly. And I think this, especially this cooperation between different countries could be a very interesting thing.
Yes.
So the idea that we had was that you, the coordinators, you will organize events to which you invite individual members and people who are interested to contribute in the party. And you will discuss the vision statement and the mission statement. And in your group, you will also discuss what you would like to change. You will be able to formulate amendments that you then on Slack can upload these amendments and send them to us.
Awesome. Huh? Yeah, exactly.
And we really want to get the individual members themselves, not only the coordinators, but the members also. We want you to get very, very active in this process, because we want to build a party that really reflects the values and the goals of all the individual members as best as possible. And it's a way also to get people finally to get them active and to get them involved, to go out. And no one stops you, by the way. Use all your ideas, you know. No one
exactly.
Wants you to go out on the street and make an event on the street and ask people in your city what they think a political party, a pan-European party should be about.
And even if you think you have a crazy idea, just your next thought should be, so what? Maybe this crazy idea will be the best idea.
Yeah. And I don't know, Talia, you probably said this already, but I didn't hear because I wasn't there. For all local events, if you want, you can always invite members of the steering committee to join you via a hangout like this one. So we will be there to maybe like for the first 20 minutes, first half hour of your event to answer questions and to give a feedback and to share your ideas with us. So.
And also we'll give you an advice. When you organize an event, just keep it in your mind, if you have a journalist or a professor or a member of a political party to support as a guest, just think you will boost your event in levels you cannot imagine. The Greeks here in Greece, we did so many events with journalists and members from the parliament, and they had all success. So it's important for you, do not be shy at all. Just ask it and be sure they will say yes, because when we know that we say, for example, that we want to people know us, this is exactly the same thing. Our politicians, our journalists, our professors, they want the same thing. So don't be shy to do that, to ask them for their help. They will do it.
Yeah, Sven writes right now that they will have their first event in Bregenz in the end of July, a great mm-hmm. opportunity to discuss the vision statement, the mission statement. And yeah, maybe we will answer us. Do you have something to add, Talia, at this point? Or do we want to take feedback from the coordinators?
And the only thing I have to add is about the academy.
Yeah.
Well, it's the last thing we need to organize it a bit. We're still in process of discussing it, where, when, with whom. So for now, you just have to know that we're in the process to organize an academy, an autumn academy, I guess, Chris, right? It will be in autumn.
Yeah, definitely.
And you will be informed for further information details later this summer.
Yeah, so basically we go now, we have the first draft of mission and vision statement. Now you discuss it with all your members, get other people involved, give us feedback, propose amendments basically in the time between May and August. Then you send us the amendments, propose it in Slack. Then we as the steering committee will review the amendment and make a second version that includes the feedback that we get from you. And then on this final version, we will have a vote in Amsterdam. And then the academy, right?
Yeah.
That will be the part that I think it was let me see, Ronald, I think was it, who asked before, okay, how do we implement this? This will be then what we will start in the academy. There we will bring lots of European liberals together, and there it will get really interesting, because then we will define the areas of action where we will actually start to do stuff to implement our vision. And we will, in this academy, we will together will decide about concrete actions that we want to take in the coming years. So.
And also, please write on our blogs, please, on our blog, upload your articles, your pieces. I'm sure you have something in your country you want to share with us, and do it. You can write something about something in your country. For example, in Germany, tomorrow there is election, and AfD takes a high number of votes. For example, we don't hope for that, but for example, this happens. So one of the coordinators, one of the members, go ahead and write something about that. Why do you think it's happening? Yeah. We really do need our pieces that show Europe and the other members that we want to share our views and our ideas and propose things. Yes, you have to be visible. Yeah. That's very, very important. We have to be visible, not only just members. Because if we are just members, then the only name you will hear is Guy Verhofstadt. Because he's visible, he's strong, he's a great politician, but the most important that he has the micro and he's visible. We can have it too. And we should use it. We have the power in our hands.
Yeah. Power to the people.
To the members. Okay.
And I see you already get started here. I see that in Neapel there will be an event organized by Francesco, Ronald and Sven. They already start discussing stuff together. Very good. Yeah, go out and get active. You know, whatever you want to do.
Okay, about Sven. Sven, if you asked me in which group on Slack, it's the coordinators. Okay, this is Ronald. He just joined. Thank you, Ronald. And then it's on. Go on Slack. You will see a channel, Country Coordinators. Join it. It has already more members now. Thank you for joining, guys. Yeah. Thank you.
So, if you guys don't have any questions left, at this point, because we want to keep our online meetings short and sweet, and then I have a question for you before we end this call. And this is, what is the first thing that you will do to start discussing this mission statement, this vision statement with your individual members? What is the first thing that you will organize, that you do?
And I will write, I will tell you then what I would do. Okay. And Chris too, yeah? Okay, we'll do that later at the end.
Good. So, Sven already is organizing an event in Bregenz. Something, Francesco is organizing something in Naples. What will you do? Federico, you're in Warsaw. What would be the easiest way for you to start this process with our members in Warsaw? What would be one thing you could do? Götz says, evening meeting with a cafe with backroom. Exactly, very simple. Götz, do you think you could organize this in the Berlin area? Oh, yeah. Ronald, very interesting. He's on a Themen team that advises one of the Austrian members of parliament. And is responsible for the discussion among members. Maybe you could organize an event together with your MP where we could discuss our mission, vision statements and see how NEOS in Austria and all the individual members could cooperate on that. Okay, René will share the in discussion in the local group. Okay. Yeah, Rainer. Recruitment tool in online legal groups, yes. I would be very glad if you also organize some like real life events. where you bring people together, maybe invite people to your home or to a cafe or so, if you feel more comfortable with that, and just get started with the discussion. And as I said before, all members of the steering committee, we are very willing to join you via Google Hangout for 30 minutes, or if it's in driving distance, we might come also somewhere. Federico needs some help with Slack. Maybe we can do this separately outside of the...
Okay, Federico, did you receive an invitation about Slack? For joining Slack, did you receive an invitation?
Ah, there will be an event in Aarhus, very great. Nado is going to India and wants to organize something in Düsseldorf once he comes back. Great. Okay. And Federico and Götz, they combine with each other.
Okay, I'm just sending an invitation to Federico, to you, Federico. So, okay, wait. Okay. Great. You just got an invitation to join Slack. Accept it, create an account. You will see, as you look, you will see on your left all the channels. You can join all the channels, of course, but ours, for now, it's the country coordinators channel. And in case you still have questions, just let me know, okay?
Yeah, and the country coordinator place is also a good place to connect with other countries if you want to organize something. So before we really finish now, because we are now 1 hour, 6 minutes, any last questions that Tali and I can answer you before we send you out into the summer weather?
Yeah.
Federico says he doesn't think so. Any questions left? Okay, then I thank you all very much for your time. It was a pleasure to talk with you, and we are looking forward. We are waiting to hear from you. We have an event here. We have an event here. We discussed this. We have these changes. Get active.
Shall I say something? Okay, what I would do, I would write a piece for our blog about what individual membership means to me and how I think we should work. I will take this article, I will use MailChimp. Do not forget MailChimp when you want to connect and say something to your members. I would send it to all my to all the members of my country. I would ask them to join me to a conversation, an event, drinks, anything, discuss it about it, and then I will start working. And I will also never forget Slack and our help. We are here to help you. Thank you for joining us. Thank you for being here today, and hope to hear from all of you very, very soon. Okay?
Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye, guys.